Hey everyone, welcome to today's lesson. Thank you for being here. It's an advanced vocabulary lesson. And this one, I think this one will be a little challenging because the way we're going to do this is I'm going to present it kind of like a quiz. And I'm going to ask you some different questions about advanced winter vocabulary. So I thought this would be relevant because it's December. Winter, depending on where you live, it could be getting much colder. But as I mentioned, these words are going to be more advanced, and some of them are also specific to the United States, which is where I am from. So keep that in mind. I'll try to give you some hints as we go through this, but the idea is to see if you know the words or try to guess them, build on your vocabulary. And I really do think that you will learn some new words today. So I did want to give a quick hello to Lolly, Rod, good to see you, Sleepwalker, Michelle Leonardo, Angela, Rosalinda, good to see so many familiar faces, excellent. As we go through this, I'll give some more shout outs because, like I said, I'm going to be asking you questions and I want you to participate. This is interactive English. I want you to participate in the lesson. One thing I did want to mention quickly is if you haven't joined our email community, you can check that out. I'm going to leave a link right there in the chat. It's also linked down in the description. You can get some lesson updates. We share useful resources, as well as give little discounts, some discounts for upcoming courses, which I'll be starting a new course next month. So you can find out about that. So let's start with the first question that I have for you, and it is this, okay? So I'll read this in case you're having difficulty seeing. I know the colors make it a little more challenging. So, a northerner who moves to a warmer southern state in the winter. Okay, I told you that this is kind of US specific. At least this question definitely is. A northerner, talking about a person who moves to a warmer southern state in the winter, is called what? This is the meaning. What is this person called? All right. What do you think? Okay, so write your answer in the chat. Hello, Loretta, Mariano, Aguirre, hello, good to see you, excellent. So what do you think? Write your answer in the chat. I'll give you a moment and then I'll tell you the answer, of course. And again, hopefully this is going to be new vocabulary for some of you. So I mentioned that this is pretty common in the United States. My family lives in Florida right now, and this is definitely common in Florida, and it's a word that is well known this time of year. So excellent, Angela, yes. Angela got the right answer. Loretta, Sani, yeah. So the correct answer, talking about a northerner, refers to a person from a northern state, or in this case, you could even say Canada, because if you live in the north in winter or you live in Canada, it gets very cold, and you maybe travel and you spend a few months down in Florida. And if that is the case, people would refer to you as a snowbird. And it's not like, this is not an offensive word or anything like that. It's just a word that's used to describe a person who does this, that they leave from the north and they go south, like to a place like Florida where it's warmer in the winter. And you would say this person is a snowbird. Okay, so the next question. All right. Again, this one, is more specific to the United States. So if some of you live there or maybe you've traveled there, then maybe you've heard of this word before. And this is, I'll read it for you. Is a storm along the east coast of North America. So-called because the winds over the coastal area are typically from the northeast. So really this is referring to a it is a storm. It's a winter storm. Usually there is snow, but there's definitely wind, and it's this big storm that people may refer to as what? So a is a storm along the east coast of North America, so called because the winds over the coastal area are typically from the northeast. Okay, this one I think is probably one of the more challenging ones that I have for you today. So the storm has a specific name. Your clue is really at the end that the winds come from the northeast. And I think unless you happen to be in the U.S. when one of these storms hit, or maybe you live there, you've spent a lot of time there, then you may have heard of this word, of what this storm is called. So I'm going to go ahead and see into people saying blizzard, hurricane. Yeah, blizzard is just the general term of a really big snowstorm, which you could use to talk about like something that's happening in any part of at least the United States or even any part of the world. There's a blizzard. Excellent. Well, very close, Cindy, very close. It's called a nor'easter. And you can see how it's spelled there, N-O-R apostrophe E-A-S-T-E-R, a nor'easter. So a nor'easter is the name of the storm, this type of storm where the winds come from the northeast. It brings a lot of snow, there's a lot of wind, and it may be referred to as a nor'easter. Okay, so this is not a very common word. It's very specific to describe this one type of storm. So I told you this was advanced. This was advanced vocabulary. All right, the next one, simple enough. What this is called, what? So I gave you the picture. I just want you to know, well, what would you call that right there? What do you think? Write your answer in the chat, in the comments. I want to hear from you. Let me know what you think. If that was a new word for you, that nor'easter, then go ahead, please hit that like button. Let me know that you, even the snowbirds, if one of those was new, hit that like button. That way, okay, it tells me like, oh, you've learned one new word today. So what do you call that? You can see what's happening in the picture. I don't want to give it away. It looks like this person has some like ice snow on the windshield of their car, and you would call it what? Excellent. Angela, Carpe Diem, Sonny, Arlinda, Anastasia, yes. So you could just call it, it is a scraper, but I would say it's being more specific, it's an ice scraper. Because it's used to scrape that ice off of your windshield, the windshield of your car, when it's really, well, cold outside, maybe there's been a bit of snow. If you live in the northeast of the United States, it's something I think people are very familiar with, having to go out there and just scrape that ice off of the windshield. Not a very fun activity, but yes, it's a scraper or an ice scraper. So the next one. Okay, this is... Well, I'll read this to you, and then you tell me if you can think of the vocabulary word that I'm going for. So this word can be used to describe the weather, and it's a synonym for cold. Of course, I think there are many synonyms for the word cold, but this one is specific. I've given you some of the letters down there. So it is it's a five-letter word, begins with a B, ends with a K. And you would use this word, you can use it to describe cold weather. And I would say not like really cold weather, but I feel like this word is definitely common in the fall as you transition into the winter. And it's getting colder. And you could say that the weather is, all right. Close. It's not bleak is not the word we're looking for. If you have any other guesses, try to write those down. Five letters, begins with a B, ends with a K. I didn't want to say just a synonym for cold because there are so many out there. I kind of wanted to try to lead you in the right direction with this one. So I'm just going to go ahead and tell you. I think people started thinking bleak. Not bleak. If you were to say like bleak, it makes me think that I feel like you're saying something is not clear. Often I think bleak would be used to describe like the future or things that may happen in the future. You can't really tell. You could say it's bleak. Muffin, yes. The answer is brisk. This is a word that I think many of you would mostly think of like brisk, something is fast or quickly. But if you're talking about the weather, then you're referring to it being cold. And like I said, I feel like it's most commonly used in like the fall as it's getting colder. Because I think sometimes when people use the word brisk, they're saying it's cold, but kind of enjoyable, that it's like a nice cold outside. So don't think of it as like really, really cold, but you could describe that the weather's a bit brisk. It's getting cold, but kind of a nice cold, all right? So again, hopefully that's a new word for you. If that's a new word, then yeah, smash that like button, all right? Let me know. It tells me like, yes, people are learning new words. So here is my next question. I've given you the meaning. I just want you to tell me, well, what is the word? What word this is the meaning for? So if you say that somebody, well, they're unable to feel anything in a particular part of your body, especially as a result of cold. Okay, so really, I know it's saying like, especially as the result of cold, but this is really, I think, mostly associated with cold. And then you're unable to feel anything, like a particular part of the body. And you could say like, my hands are or my nose is or what would you say? I'm trying to think of other body parts. Mostly I feel like you'd say like your hands or your nose, maybe even your face a little bit because they're not covered. And you can't feel anything, you would say they are what, all right? So you guys are kind of close. Yes, excellent. Louis, Olga, Be Happy, Farstre, Takayao. Hello, Takayao, good to see you. Aaron, Cindy, Muffin. The correct answer is numb in this case. So just saying that you're unable to feel something, then you would say numb. It's numb. And like I said, it says especially it happens in the cold. And I think, yes, when it's cold outside, if parts of your body are not covered, then you may lose feeling and you'd say, yeah, they're numb. My hands are a bit numb. All right, that's different than one of the other answers that people were providing. But I'm going to circle back to that a little bit later on. So the next one is another picture vocabulary question for you. So hopefully you can see that picture right there. Whoops. What do you call the blade at the front of the truck? So just looking at that picture, there's that blade at the front. What is that called? All right. What do you think? And this is even the truck. Then if you talk about the truck, the name of the truck basically is called using the name of that blade. So what would you say? That blade is just pushing the snow out of the way, off of the street, and well, the truck is called a and I don't want to give you the answer, but that blade also has a specific name. And what would you call it? What would you say? So I think we're learning some new words today, because sometimes I know people will just run right through these answers. And I think some of the ones coming up are going to be a little bit easier, probably a little more common. But I told you this is advanced winter vocabulary. So the correct answer is a plow. All right. And you would say that that truck is a snow plow. Now, plow, actually, you could have either one of two spellings. I think in the United States, most people are going to spell it PLOW. A snow plow is what I would call that truck. But specifically, that blade is referred to as the plow. So this is a snow plow, is one of those trucks you would see on the street in the winter if there's a lot of snow and it's just pushing that snow off of the street. A snow plow. All right, the next one. Now you have two pictures of me up here. This is a picture, this is from the thumbnail. So, if I were to say, like, just giving you context, and I want you to think of the missing word. If I were to say, okay, I'm still cold wearing this coat, I need to get a new one with more. What am I referring to? How would I complete that sentence given that situation? I'm wearing this coat, but I'm still cold, so I say, I need to get a new one. I'm talking about getting a new coat. But a coat that has more . And in that case, it's going to keep me warmer. So what word would you use? And I think this is fairly common, and you could use this word to talk about things other than just like coats or jackets or things that you would wear. So I'm talking about this coat. I need to get one with more what? Okay, so all right. So if you just joined us, we're doing some advanced winter vocabulary. Please participate in the lesson. Write your answer in the chat, in the comments as we go through these. So think about the situation. Let me explain this a little more. So I'm wearing this coat. It's not warm enough. I need to get another one that's going to keep in the heat. So some of you put like a down. Down is a type of jacket that somebody would wear. Fluff. You wouldn't say fluff or feathers because again, it depends on what type of jacket you're wearing. This is a coat, so this is more of a winter coat. And in that case, you're talking about. You need something that's going to stop the heat from escaping, which, given that phrase, stopping the heat from escaping, the meaning of that, we're talking about insulation. So it's like, oh, I need a coat with more insulation that's going to keep that air in and not let it escape. And I told you could hear people talking about insulation when referring to clothing. But they may also talk about insulation, talking about like a home. If you're inside some building or some place and it's cold in there because the heat is escaping, then you could also say, yeah, our home needs a little more insulation in order to keep the heat from escaping. All right, excellent. So that's a good word. Good word to know in the wintertime because this word is often used in the wintertime because you're talking about heat escaping. So the next one that I have for you is this one. Again, I'm giving you the meaning. I just want you to think of the vocabulary word. It's talking about injury to someone caused by severe cold, usually to their toes, fingers, ears, or nose that causes permanent loss of tissue. Okay, this is a specific word that. It can happen in the wintertime, especially if it's very, very cold outside. It's not something that you want to happen. Sometimes you could even end up in the hospital and have to go to the doctor. So what do you think? We're talking about injury caused by severe cold. Usually toes, fingers, ears, nose can cause permanent loss. All right, everybody is. Answering this one, because I know many people had said this for the previous one, but yes, excellent. Great job. Let's see, Farste, Michelle Leonardo, Carpe Diem, Nichelon, Sleepwalker, Lolly, Cindy, Renee, Muffin. Yeah, so we're talking about frostbite. So before, when I mentioned like a loss of feeling, in that case, you would just say like numb. Numb is not, it's not like you're in any immediate danger. You just can't feel it. And maybe you need to put some gloves on. If you get frostbite, then that can be a real problem. We're talking about the, it's like it says, severe cold that is going to damage like your fingers or ears, and like you get frostbite. So there is definitely a distinction between numb and frostbite. I think at first, like your nose, your toes, your fingers would become numb. And then if it's still cold, it's getting colder, then you could end up getting frostbite. All right, excellent. The next one. Okay, so again, I'm giving you more of like a sentence, a statement, and I want you to try to put it in context. So if this is a situation and I say, it's 2 degrees outside, but it's really windy. So with the factor, it feels like -5. So which word comes before factor? And I would say this is actually a collocation, an factor. So think about the situation. I think you can understand it. Try to put it in context and think of what word would best complete that sentence. Even if you don't know, this word, I think maybe based on the situation, you could maybe even just come up with it on your own. So it's 2 degrees outside, but it's really windy. So with the factor, it feels like -5. So again, this is another word that I think it's pretty common in the winter. Because often, depending on where you live, there are some windy days. And you know that the weather has a certain temperature. But with the wind, it becomes a lot colder. And that is referred to as the wind chill. The wind chill. And as I said, this is, I think, a pretty common collocation. People would talk about the wind chill factor. It's like, well, it's 0 degrees outside. And you might ask, well, what's the wind chill factor? Like, how cold is it now with the wind, because it's a windy day, the wind chill factor. Excellent. Let's see. I got some different answers. You guys very, I think, close with that one. Perfect. All right. So yeah, wind chill. Again, if this is a word that you haven't heard of, it's a great word to know. But again, it's very relevant, the winter time. Because this is when you are likely going to hear it. Thank you, Rod. Glad you enjoy this lesson. I hope you guys are learning some new words. If you are, again, hit that like button. It tells me that you are learning new things and that, yeah, in the future, I should try and do some more advanced lessons like this. Maybe some more advanced vocabulary related to a specific topic. So this one, I think, is... I guess I'd say it is a more advanced word, but it's one that I think many of you are probably a bit more familiar with. So just think of the situation, bears during winter, all right? Maybe not this bear right here in the picture, but in general, when you think of bears and you think of winter, what do they do during winter? And then not just bears, I think there are many other animals out there that do this in the winter. Because it's so cold, they try to just get the heck out of there. And the word we're looking for is hibernate. And as I said, I think many of you know that word. Great job, Lolly, Sleepwalker, Zarna, Anastasia, Sarah, excellent. So you'd say bears hibernate in the winter. To hibernate is just to kind of, it's, I think, more so it refers to like inactivity in order to kind of protect yourself, keep yourself out of the cold in this case. So bears hibernate during winter. The next one, this one I think is going to be a little more challenging. This question right here, it's, well, I'm giving you the meaning, but it is a very, it's a specific word. So the meaning of it is a bank of deep snow heaped up by the wind. That is the meaning that I got from the internet, from the online dictionary. So what would you call that in English? You're talking about that deep bank of snow, maybe referred to as a what? And I, like I said, I think this is more challenging. I would say it's not, I don't want to say it's not common. I think this is a word you would hear, especially if you live in a place where you get a lot of snow that piles up over throughout the winter, and it creates this what? Close, Anastasia. Yes, Lolly. Excellent. You got it. So the word that we're looking for is it's a drift, a snow drift. So when that snow piles up over time throughout the winter, you could say it just creates this snow drift where it's heaped up on top of one another. And it's some of them can be very deep. And that's another way in which you may hear people talk about a snow drift if they happen to step into it and then they're up to their waist in snow. The next one is probably one that you are not going to need to use in your everyday life. I don't know how many of you have been dog sledding before, but it is one that you may come across in a story. If you're reading a story about somebody who is dog sledding, or I don't know, you think about the Iditarod, that dog sled race. So, is the command used to get a dog team moving forward? What is the word traditionally that somebody would use? I don't know if it's still very common today, but traditionally people would use this command to get the dog team moving forward, and they would say, what is the command? Well, they wouldn't say but they would say this word. And that is the command to, like, okay, start going, let's go. So I saw a correct answer in there. Yak Binir. All right, sorry if Yukon Cornelius. Sorry if I mispronounced that name. Angela, yes. So the word, the command that I'm talking about is mush. And like I said, this is one maybe you would come across in a story, or if you're watching some TV show or movie, possibly for kids, and there is some dog sled team in there, and they're saying, mush, mush, like, okay, let's go, let's start moving, mush. The next one, okay, what do you think? So this is talking about the condition of having an abnormally, typically dangerously, low body temperature. What would you say? What is that condition called? This is, I think, it's a common word. You would hear this depending on, I don't know, a certain situation. You know, if it's really cold outside and your body temperature starts to, you know, it's lowering and it gets to a point to where it's dangerously low, you can get what? And again, I think this is a word that if you can't think of it right now, I imagine that you've probably heard of this word. As I said, I think it's pretty common. Excellent. The answer, I'll go ahead and tell you because you guys are writing it in there quickly, is hypothermia. Great job, Lolly, Olga, Sinjana, Erlinda, Esrei, Aaron. Yes, so hypothermia is talking about that condition where your body temperature is lowering. So again, keep some of those distinctions in mind. We mentioned like numb, that you can't feel something, you've lost your feeling. Frostbite is when you're damaging the tissue. And like I said, that's dangerous. Hypothermia refers to your body temperature. And when it gets too low, you can get hypothermia. So yeah, I think, let me see, is that That is all. So though I'm putting the list of words up here for you. Again, if you just wanted to have another look at them. I hope some of these words were new. I hope you enjoyed the quiz. I hope you learned some new words. Again, if you did learn some new words, please hit that like button, share the lesson too. I would really appreciate that. It helps us build our global community, our community of English learners. So the other thing that I want to just end on is tell you, yes, these are advanced words. They're more specific. So you are going to hear them in a certain context when somebody's talking about one of these situations and you come across this word. So just keep that in mind, that they are very specific. It's great to learn new words, especially, I think, advanced words. It allows you to be more precise if you're trying to describe something and talk about it. Like I had mentioned, the distinction between like numb or frostbite and hypothermia, very useful, very good information to know. So again, please again, join our email community. I've linked it down in the description. If you have not joined the Interactive English team, thank you, Lolly, Angela, Michelle, Leonardo. Glad you guys enjoyed the lesson. Merry Christmas to you guys too. Sanjana, Esrae, I really appreciate it. Lolly, you learned a lot of new words. Excellent. I figured that quite a few of these would be new because, like I said, I think they are definitely more specific, which, yes, more advanced. Okay, I'm going to stop rambling. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you enjoy the rest of your weekend, and I will see you next time.